Hey guys, this is Brian, aka Texas Treasures, and today I'm sipping my coffee, starting the Saturday morning, right? I wanted to talk to you guys about items that I have sold on Poshmark that can help make you good money. These are 50 items that have sold for $50 or more on Poshmark. These are brands that can help you make money, so I'm making this video to help you know what to look for when you're outsourcing out in the wild for those treasures to help improve your bottom line and to have good flips on Poshmark. So stick around to check it out. Back at the computer, and I'm going to show you 50 items that have sold for $50 or more for me recently on Poshmark. Once again, trying to help you understand the things that you can look for when you're outsourcing to pick up that are worth good money. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, hit the subscribe button, smash the like button, and comment below what are some of the items that you've sold recently for $50. Let's get straight into it. All right. Here we have a pair of 2008 men's not Nuke, but Nike Shocks. Picked these up at a garage sale. And I'm going to go kind of quick because there are 50 and this can take a while. So I got a pair of Nike shoes picked up at a garage sale for, I believe it was $2. Same garage sale, picked up a pair of Merrell. Merrell is a good brand to be looking for. These are waterproof outdoor shoes, also sold for $50. All right, another garage sale find. I think I paid $3 for these. These are a pair of Converse All-Star Zebra Patchwork. These are the tall ones. These are a women's size 9. These sold for $50. Here we have Brooks, a pair of running shoes, the Adrenaline GTS 18. These also sold for $50. And here we have a pair of cowboy boots. If you've watched my videos, you'll know that I sell a lot of cowboy boots. These are Herman Survivors Cowboys Work Boots with a steel toe. Also sold for $5. I picked these up, not $5, sold for $50. I picked them up for $5. Here we have a pair of Keen, another pair of men's work boots, safety boots, steel toe. Also sold for $50. Keen is a good brand to be on the lookout for. Here we have a pair of vintage L.L. Bean duck boots, size 10. These sold for $50 as well. As you can see, I used to focus solely on shoes. Since I started doing storage units, I do sell more things, but you will see a lot of shoes, and that is a good niche to get into if you're trying to hit that $50 plus price point. Here we have a pair of Doc Martens, black Oxfords, men's size 13. Which is my size. Thought about keeping them. Paid $3.50 for them. Picked these up at the Goodwill outlet. Sold them for $50. And here's Nike. You see Nike making another appearance. Pair of Air Force One low top. Notice this unique colorway, the purple and black. Air Force Ones are always going to sell for good money. Paid up $10 for this at a thrift store. They sold for $51. By the way, make sure you stick around all the way till the end because these are going up in price. They start off at $50 and they do go up. So make sure you stick around to the very end to see the best price items that sold recently. Here we have a pair of Laredo lace-up suede boots, women's size 7.5. These sold for $52 on Poshmark. And here we have another pair of Brooks. So you can see Brooks is a good running brand, running shoe brand. So if you see Brooks, look them up. They're usually going to be worth good money if they have, you know, you do want to check the bottoms of the outer soles. Make sure you have good traction. But assuming that's the case, you should be in good shape. These Ghost 10 sold for $52 on Poshmark. All right, here we have another pair of hiking boots. You can see hiking boots sell for good money. These are the Vasque Breeze GTX Vibram. It's a good keyword to look for. These hiking boots sold for $52 on Poshmark. And once again, another pair of these hiking boots. These are Rocky Blizzard Stalker. They're waterproof with a steel toe. You can do some serious damage in these. In these bad boys. These sold for $53 on Poshmark. Boots. And let's switch it up to the women's boots. Next, moving up, we have a pair of Uggs. These are the classic short black ones. Picked these up for $3 at the Goodwill outlet. By the way, I haven't been to the Goodwill outlet in quite a while. I haven't been to a garage sale in quite a while. I've been working on knocking out my death pile from the last storage unit, and I think pretty soon I'm going to have to go back. I'm kind of having that missing the sourcing blues. We got to take care of that. Here we have a pair of cowboy boots, Nakona black leather cowboy boots, size 8D. These sold for $54. Picked them up for $9 at a thrift store. Cowboy boots. Ooh, that's not even a good picture. Look how gray that is. Before I was using photo fuse and not very good lighting at all. But anyway, still sold for $54. Imagine if I would have taken a better picture. You can see one of the trends that's emerging, right? Boots, especially men's boots. Here we have a pair of Red Wing men's brown leather boots. These sold for $55 on Poshmark. I don't remember if I picked these up at a thrift store or a garage sale, but they were a nice flip. Okay, Crocs. Here we have a pair of Crocs. I do remember picking these up at a garage sale. I think I paid $5 for these. Now, the thing about these, notice how these are different. They're two-tone, right? They are Crocs. But they have the laces, they have this leather up here. So when the Crocs, the more unusual they tend to be worth more money. These sold for $55 on Poshmark. Remember, these are all items that sold for $50 or more recently on Poshmark, items that you can find when you're outsourcing that can make you good money. So get your pen and paper out, take some notes, comment below what are some items that you've sold for $50? Let me know. Here we have another pair of Uggs. I think it's the second pair of Uggs to make the list. And these are the Australia La Jolla Brown Suede Sheepskin, style number 5587. Did pay up for these at a thrift store. I paid a whopping $16, but they did sell for $55 on Poshmark. Sometimes it's okay to pay up. You will just do your research, and good research, you should know what the value is. Here we have another pair of cowboy boots. These are Justin men's leather ropers, style number 3133. Paid $7.50 at the thrift store. They sold for $57. And here we have another pair of Brooks, right? So a list like this, it is long. There are 50 items, but when you do a longer list, you're able to kind of see some of these trends, right? We have a pair of Brooks Adrenaline GTS 18 women's running shoes. Paid $6 for these at a thrift store, and they sold for $57 on Poshmark. And there's another Brooks Adrenaline GTS 17, the edition right before the 18, size 6.5, paid $5 at a thrift store, and they sold for $57. Brooks are a great shoe to be on the lookout for, as I said previously. Patagonia. Here we have a pair of Patagonia hiking shoes. These I paid $6 at the thrift store, and they sold for $57. Patagonia hiking shoes. I haven't seen a lot of these, but definitely worth some good money. Here we have another pair of cowboy, or should I say cowgirl boots. We have the women's zebra print. Notice this unusual print with a cross. These really stood out when I saw them. I remember I picked these up at the Goodwill outlet where they sell by the pound. I think it came out to probably about $3 on the cost. They sold for $60. All right, another thrift store find as we keep moving up higher and higher in the price values. Make sure you stick around to the end to see those highest priced items. Here we have a pair of Salvatore Ferragamo. It's a great brand. These are women's green suede pumps, size 9B. Paid $5 at the thrift store, and these sold for $60. And here we have another Goodwill outlet find. Tory Burch. Yes, you can find Tory Burch at the Goodwill outlet. Pair of pumps, size 10M, which is a large size in the women's size, the red and gold. Now, the interesting story on this, I found one, and a lady came up to me with the second one, and we ended up flipping a coin to see who would get the pair. I lucked out and won the coin toss, paid $3.50 at the Goodwill outlet, sold them for $60. Obviously, Tory Burch is a great brand, if you can find it, when you can find it. And here we have a repeat. Well, I want to say a Fender. I don't know if it's really an Fender, but we have a repeat brand. Doc Martens. These are women's combat boots. Did pay up for these. These were also a thrift store find. I paid $18.19, and these sold for $60. $60. All right. As we are in mid to late February, these boots are probably being put to use right now. Picked these up at a thrift store. I don't remember what I paid for them. I want to say $7 or $8. These are Baffin Men's Punisher Snow Boots. They are designed heavy insulation. These are the polar design for the cold. They sold for $60 on Poshmark. I'm always looking for boots when I see them. Going to look them up. Going to see what they're selling for. Oh my gosh, here we go. We might have, this is probably the most prevalent brand on my 50 for 50. These are a pair of Brooks Glycerin 13 women's running shoes. Paid $9 and sold them for $60 on Poshmark. Running shoes, they get worn out. They're going to get replaced. People come looking for a good deal. Just make sure they got good tread and they're in good shape, and you'll have no problems. And here we have another pair of Doc Martens, right? I think it's the third, probably the third pair on my 50 for 50. Pick these up. Let's see. Yeah, notice the split toe right here on these Oxford lace-ups. Paid $7 for them. Sold them for $63 on Poshmark. First Mizuno on the list. Another pair of running shoes. These are men's Mizuno Wave Creation 13s. Paid up. Paid $10 and change at the thrift store, but they sold for $65. Mizuno can be worth money. All these running shoes, learn them, study them. And here's another pair of running shoes. We got Brooks Glycerin 12 men's running shoes, the blue and gold colorway with the silver highlights. Picked these up for $5 at a thrift store and flipped it for $65. Shoes, as you can see, shoes can make you really good money. Just got to know which ones to look for, which is why I'm making this video to help you out. Here we have a pair of Timberland. Oh, notice here, I think I used Photo Fuse on this, got that pure white background finally. These are safety steel toe shoes, paid up $17. And that's the thing, guys, it's okay to pay up as long as the research shows that you're gonna make a good profit. It's okay to pay $17 because I sold them for $69 on Poshmark. They also had the box, which is unusual. Actually, I wonder, I think I might have actually picked these up at a garage sale. You don't usually find them with a box at a thrift store. I could be wrong. When you buy and sell so many things, it's hard to remember everything. All right, here we have another pair of duck boots for when it's rainy outside. The brand is Sorel. Paid $5 and change at the thrift store. Sold them for $70. $70. Sorrel duck boots. They're similar to L.L. Bean, and they are worth good money. Good money, money. Remember, I picked these up, did pay up, paid $20 for these at a garage sale. I remember I negotiated. The lady was asking like $40, which was way too much, and did come agree to $20 based on comps on the solds, and it was okay to pay $20 because I sold them for $70. Don't be scared to get out there and negotiate. Never give the first offer at a garage sale. Always let them give you the first offer and try to negotiate as low as possible. Okay, here we have another thrift store find. These are a pair of Cole Haans. This is a zero grand Oxford style, paid $6 at the thrift store and sold them for $70. And here we have a pair of Hoka 1-1. That's another good running brand. The Clifton 4s, women's running shoes, paid $7 at the thrift store and sold these for $70. Again, that 10X, guys, that 10X, that's the kind of return we're looking for. We love it. We love it. We love it a lot. And here, as the prices keep getting higher on the 50 for 50, we have a pair of Kohlhein leather Oxford wingtip shoes, paid $9 at the thrift store, and they sold for $72. All right, here's our next Tory Burch. This was also a Goodwill outlet find, and I've probably been 4 or 5 times. It has been a while since I've been. Kind of been doing storage units lately, but I do want to get back to the Goodwill outlets. Found these beautiful wedge platform, golden color. They stood out. I couldn't believe when I found them there. Paid about $250, remember, price per pound at the Goodwill outlet or bins, and they sold for $80. Beautiful shoes, Tory Burch. Going to sell high and it's going to sell fast. And when you find it at the Goodwill, you know you are having a good day. Good day, good day. Okay, more men's work boots. Picked these up at a garage sale. Garage sale, I paid $4 for these. Came with a box. They were like new. The bottoms on them were perfect. They might have been worn once or twice. And I was able to sell these steel toe twisted X work shoes for $89. 4 into 89. I'll take it all day, every day. Be look on the lookout for them. Here's another garage sale find. I was out garage selling my friend Clay, aka the Eclectic Elephant. He's also on YouTube. And I saw these at a garage sale. I did pay up, I want to say 10. I think I paid $10 for these. But they sold for $90 on Poshmark. Notice the photo fuse here. That gives you that pure white background, the difference between this and that. This or that. I'll take that. And those pure white backgrounds give you more money. Make sure you're using photo fuse. Unlike this one. So you can see that the times on these are from different times. Here we have another garage sale find. I paid $3 for these. These are vintage Larry Mahan exotic boots, ostrich skin, cowboys, cowboy style. They sold for $97. I paid $3 at a garage sale. Here in Texas, obviously, we find a lot of cowboy boots. Look them up when you find them because they can be worth some good money, guys. All right. Next, we have a pair of Blundstone. That is a great brand. If you see it, Blundstone 500 Chelsea is the style. These are women's boots. Actually, it's one of those that women's or men's. Women's size 9, men's size 7. Paid up for these. Paid $10 in change at the thrift store, but they sold for $99 on Poshmark. Blundstone. Basically, anytime I see boots of any kind, I'm going to check them out. Doesn't mean all boots are worth money, but a lot of them are. Here, speaking of boots, we have a pair of Justin Western cowboy boots, lizard skin, style number 8301. Notice the silver tip on this. Got the lizard skin, the leather uppers. Paid $14 at the thrift store, but that's okay because they sold for $99. $99, another pair of Justin cowboy boots. Look for cowboy boots. Look for Justin. Look them up. I remember finding these beautiful shoes. Picked these up at a garage sale for $8. I paid $8 for these. They caught my attention, the pink and gold. Didn't even do the research. I knew that they were worth good money. Turns out they are, and they're very hard to find, a 2008 edition of the Air Force Ones. They were released on Valentine's Day. What Why give your sweetheart chocolates or diamonds or candy when you can give her a beautiful pair of Nike Air Force Ones? Turned $8 from a garage sale into a crisp, clean $100 bill on Poshmark. Okay, and here we have a suit, a Ralph Lauren men's suit, size 46R. Probably paid a couple bucks for these. Usually I get these pretty cheap suits when I buy them are under five. They do take a little bit more time to list. They do take a little bit more time to sell, but they typically will sell for good money if you learn your brands, and obviously Ralph Lauren is a good brand. These sold for $108.99. That is a beautiful sell. All right, here we have another garage sale find. I think I was with my friend Clay also when I picked these up. Paid $8 at a garage sale. I remember he walked by them. Even though I taught him to look for the cowboy boots like I'm telling you guys, he wasn't sure. He walked by them. I scooped them up. If you're watching this, Clay, tell me how do you feel now when you realize you missed these beautiful coral Cayman. Was it alligator or crocodile? Cayman crocodile, I think, leather snip toe, which is that toe right there. Cowboy boots, beautiful boots. Sold for $115. I paid for $8. I didn't negotiate with a guy at the garage sale. I think originally he wanted $20. Did some Texas treasure style negotiations and walked out there paying $8 and turned the $8 into $115. We're going on up, guys. All right, this is a fairly, really recent sell. This is from one of my storage units, a Salvatore Ferragamo men's reversible leather belt. You can say on average, I probably paid a dollar or less, because when you buy storage units and they're filled with clothing, the price per item is really cheap. So this for $120 is sold within a day or two of being listed. Salvatore Ferragamo, just like those women's green pumps earlier. On the men's side, it goes for even more money. And this belt was no exception. $120. All right. Here, this was from an estate sale. I picked this up for $5. I remember I was with my mom at the time. She wanted to learn how to do this. I was teaching her. Saw this vintage, I believe it's from the 50s, Smithwick Lure Shreveport Floater, model F-108. Had the original box. How cool is that? How cool is that? The original price tag, I don't remember what it said. It was a ridiculously low amount. And I sold it for $138.77. All right, we're getting close to the end, guys. Remember, these are 50 items I sold for $50 or more. Trying to help you know which items you should be looking for when you're sourcing. And you should have picked up on some trends or themes by now. Here we have a, guess what, another pair of cowboy boots. These are on the girls' side. These are the tall Ariat Hacienda, beautiful boots. And I did use my leather conditioner on this. I do need to make a video on that. By the way, if you look in the description below, you will see all the products that I use in my business, including to clean up shoes. It's worth it to clean up these leather shoes. You'll get more money. I remember I picked this up at a thrift store. I think it was $8, $7 or $8, and they sold for $130 on Poshmark, and they sold within a couple of days. Beautiful boots, very stylish, very rare. And boots, gotta love those boots. Okay, and here, I think this is number 50, I'm not sure, let's see. Here we have, I think we're gonna finish with a pair of Lucchese black leather buffalo cowboy boots, sold for $175. I paid up for these at a thrift store. I think I paid $25, but they sold for $175. Cowboy boots are big. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, hit the subscribe, smash the like button, comment below, tell me what are some items you sold for over $50, and I hope you picked up on some trends. We have what? Let's, off the top of my head, we have Nike, we have Brooks, we have cowboy boots, we have hiking boots, we have snow boots, we got all the boots, we got all the shoes. Be on the lookout for them, guys. They'll bring you good money. Until next time, happy treasure hunting.